As you can see, I've got the turnaround installed, tracks in place, and you can see how it runs up and around. I've mounted it to the helix with these metal brackets, and this is pretty much all they are, just purchased from Home Depot. No big deal. Screwed them in place. And then right here I have a splice plate to keep the upper area nice and level so the track sits nice and flush. Soldered the rail joints. And there it is. Here you can see the bridge. I'm going to be replacing that bridge with this bridge from Cotto. I'm going to weather it up a little bit and add some decals to it so it looks a little bit better, but that's going to replace that little crummy little Atlas bridge right there. Over here you can see where it comes up around. And I'll start working on the track work right in here. The other part I've been working on is the south yard area, which is the engine facility basically. And as you can see in the track plan right there, that's the section we installed earlier. If you pan on over to here, here it is. And it actually looks pretty good. That's the engine facility in south yard. And this is the new section that we installed in. Fueling racks, sanding racks, rip area, main bypass, and the main's going to come around here on the back. Caboose track, this is Old Pueblo right here. We've swung around to the Old Pueblo section right here. Old Pueblo yard is right here. There's a station in the back because I'm running out of room. Junk everywhere, but I'll clean it up eventually.